I want to talk a little bit about your story, but before we do, of course, yesterday was Youth Day and today's Nature Day. Why do you think that's so important to have something like these two significant days in COP?
I think you hit the nail on the head earlier when you used the words empowered youth, because I think it's one thing to encourage youth to participate, to encourage youth to come to events like this, but it's an entirely different thing to provide a space where youth feel empowered to be able to drive change. Mm-hmm. And the reason that Youth Day is so important is we need to start recognizing young people for the value that they are and the resource that they are. Because often we start to see young people as these splashes of color or bits of intrigue that you can add to an event. And I think that, I mean, for want of a better word, I think that's really disgusting. But actually, we need to start recognizing that there are young people who are entrepreneurs, who are economists, who are kind of budding career diplomats. And I think we need to find ways of ensuring that we're taking that resource base, that we're supporting it, that we're nurturing it, so that we don't end up in the situation that we are now. Because, I mean, the climate crisis, the environmental crisis, the ecological crises, these are all results of poor leadership and bad decision-making processes and mechanisms that have just been allowed to continue to perpetuate a cycle of environmental degradation. And the result is the climate crisis that we have now. So it's really encouraging this kind of new generation of leaders that have an opportunity to steer a different course. Mm-hmm.